Hello friends, today we are going to compare the K-epsilon model and Reynolds stress turbulence model. For this comparison, I have taken a convergent divergent nozzle. Initially open the geometric module in Ansys Fluent Flow. First, we will create the sketch for a convergent divergent nozzle with the help of revolving option. Initially draw the two dimensional sketch. First draw one horizontal line, then give dimension as 0.05 meter. Then you can draw one vertical line, give the dimension, the dimension is 0.15 meter. Again, you can draw one horizontal line on the top of the vertical line. And give the dimension as 0.05 meter. Now draw the convergent portion. Then you can draw the throat section. Then you can draw the divergent section. Now you can give dimension for these sections. The dimensions of the throat section is 0.02 meter. The length of the convergent section is 0.05 meter. Radius of the throat section is 0.025 meter. Now click generate and go to modeling section for revolving this sketch. Now click revolve option. Select axis, select the middle axis. Now click generate for revolving the sketch. Now you can see the convergent divergent nozzle in three-dimensional view. After creating three dimensional view, now we have to specify boundary conditions. Select surfaces option, then click the surface of the convergent portion. Give the surface name as inlet and click generate. Now go to outer portion of the divergent portion and select the surface and right click, give named selection and then give name as outlet. Now click control and select remaining surfaces. Now right click, select named selection and give the name as wall and click generate. Now we have specified all the boundary conditions. Now the geometric module is over. Now go to mesh section, open the mesh module, Now double click the mesh and in assembly meshing you have to choose tetrahedron and in sizing option select fine relevant center and high smoothing options, then click update. Now the fine tetrahedral mesh is generated for this convergent divergent nozzle. Now open the fluent setup option. Here first I am going to set K epsilon model. For this model we are going to predict velocity magnitude. Here click double precision and serial processing option, click OK. Now the mesh model is loaded in Fluent Flow. Here I am going to select transient mode and pressure based solver type and absolute velocity formulation option. Next go to models. Here go to viscous laminar. Here I am going to select K epsilon model. It is a two equation model. Here standard K epsilon model I am going to utilize. Click OK. And go to materials. In materials go into fluent database. Here select water vapor as a fluid. Here we are going to inject water vapor in the inlet of the convergent divergent nozzle. Now we have changed fluid material as water vapor. Go to cell zone conditions and click edit. Here material name is water vapor. Click OK. Then go to boundary conditions. Select inlet option. Here we have to provide a velocity inlet and give edit. Give velocity magnitude as 10 meter per second. Remaining options are same and give OK. And go to outer boundary condition. Here pressure outer boundary condition is chosen. There is no change. Click OK. And go to wall boundary condition and give OK. Then go to solution methods. Here select second order upwind for turbulent kinetic energy and turbulent dissipation rate. And go to solution initialization. Select hybrid initialization. Then initialize. Now you can see the hybrid initialization is done. And go to patch. Select Y velocity. Because the fluid flow through in Y direction. Here you have to give 10 meter per second. Select solid and give patch and close. Now run the calculations. Here specify the time step size. Here I am going to give 0.0001 and number of time steps as 3 and maximum iteration per time step is 20. Now run the calculation. Now we can see the calculation is completed. The solution is converged at 68th iteration. Now go to graphics and animation section. Select contours. Here you have to select filled options. Now select surfaces. Now select all the surfaces. Now let us see the contours of static pressure. Now you can see the velocity magnitude. Now the maximum velocity is 43.95 meter per second. Now go to plane surface option. Here you have to specify all the points x, y, z points as 0 except y 0. Here you have to provide 1 and click create the plane and go to setup. Now you have select the plane 4 option only and click display. Now you can see the midsection plane of the convergent divergent nozzle. Now go to reports option. Here you have to select volume integrals. Here in field variables you have to select velocity and select solid cell zones and give compute. And now you can see the predicted velocity is 19.034 meter per second. Now we will check the velocity magnitude in Reynolds stress turbulence model. For this, same dimensions of the convergent divergent nozzle. Now close the fluent and reset fluent setup only. No need to reset mesh and geometry. Only you have to reset fluent setup option only. Initially we have to clear the data from solution option, then we have to clear the data from setup option. It means you have to reset the data from solution option. Next we have to reset data from setup option. No need to reset mesh and geometry. You have to repeat the procedure same. Now the nozzle is loaded in fluent setup manual. Now select transient mode and go to models, select viscous laminar. Here we are going to select Reynolds stress model. It is a 7 step equation turbulence model. Here select linear pressure strain Reynolds stress model and click OK. You have to give same fluid. It means you have to select water vapor in fluent fluid materials. Follow the same procedure. Boundary conditions also same. Give velocity inlet boundary condition and pressure outer boundary condition. For the wall boundary condition, you have to select no slip wall boundary condition. Now we can initialize the solution with the help of hybrid initialization. Now hybrid initialization is done. Now we can run the calculation. Now the calculation is running. After the solution is converged, then you can read the velocity magnitude value. Now we can see the solution is converged. Now similarly go to graphics and animation and select contours. Here we can see the static pressure contour for all the surfaces. And go to velocity magnitude. Here the maximum velocity is 44.5 meter per second. Here only 1 meter per second only deviated from K epsilon model. And click surface and select plane for viewing the midsection of the convergent divergent nozzle. Now go to reports and select volume integrals. In field variables, you have to select velocity magnitude. Now click compute. Now you can see the predicted velocity is 19.12 meter per second. The predicted velocity is 19.12 meter per second from the null stress turbulence model. The predicted velocity from K epsilon model is 19.03 meter per second. There is no any large deviation. 0.1 meter per second only deviated. If you want to take contours, go to save picture option. Then you can save the pictures. Thank you.